What in the hey have the Hanks been up to? Well, hold the phone. We're gonna get into that in just a minute.
So, how about that tsunami?
Well, we just got a tsunami warning, 11 o'clock at night. This is terrifying.
I'll tell you what, if I ever felt like I needed to call family and say goodbye, that was the moment. It's one of those scenarios where you see those warnings come through and you're just like, I don't know, is this serious? And when you talk to the locals, which we did, the camp host called us, and we also talked to a state trooper. They were like, you know what? It's not really gonna affect us. It's far away. We're keeping an eye on it. Listen for those words when you talk to a local about any emergent disaster. I don't know if you've ever seen the video of the guy who's mowing the grass and there's a tornado behind him, probably somewhere in Kansas or Oklahoma, and the wife is like, Frank, get inside, the tornado's right behind you. And he's like,
I'm keeping an eye on it.
You Florida people like to keep an eye on those hurricanes.
Mm-hmm.
Death and destruction happens a lot over the country when it comes to like nature forces. Back where I'm from in Pennsylvania, floods happen a lot, especially in the summer, and they kill a lot of people. But do we take it serious enough when there's flood warnings? We do not. People still go out and drive because they're like, oh, I'll be fine. I don't, you know, it's okay. There's always flood warnings. And then that's the moment that something terrible happens. I'm an ER nurse, so like I'm in action mode when it's like, here's what needs to be done. But when we get that tsunami warning and reality hit that this is affecting us and this could be like a really serious thing, I kind of froze up. If you refer to the footage, I kind of just sat there, and when everyone had to make a decision on where to go, I was like, terrifying stuff, I'll tell you what. I think we did the right thing, and I know some of you guys in the comments are gonna be saying that we panicked. And that's okay. I'm okay with you saying, ah, we're from Alaska, we get that all the time. Well, you know what? I want you to go to Tornado Alley and see how much you panic when there's a tornado warning that just boom, out of nowhere. And a lot of you guys reach out and say, I want it full time, but I'm nervous about going somewhere where there's bad weather, hurricanes, tornadoes, floods, tsunamis. I hear ya. It's kind of part of the adventure. With that being said, always go with your gut instinct, guys. I am not a weather professional. I'm barely an RV professional, but you still choose to watch. I also want to say thank you to our camp host, Leanne. You called us. I answered the phone. I was probably like, hala. But you gave us good reassurance and you like made me feel really good and safe. And I appreciate that. Gosh, I have so much to tell you guys, but once again, we are running behind when it comes to checkout, okay? So we gotta go, but I will update you when we're on the road. Hey, Carl, are we ready to go or what?
Ready, Freddy.
I ain't complaining today because you know what? It's not too bad of a drive day and we get to stop and take a hike halfway through. Take a hike halfway through the drive? Hanks, what are you up to? Well, we'll let you in on that secret here in just a minute. It's gonna be a good one.
Today, we are gonna stop and do a hike. We've never done that before. We're hoping there's gonna be enough parking for both RVs at the trailhead. I don't know. You guys are basically along for the journey to see how this works. We don't usually do this. Like if we go on hikes, we take the RV to a campground, we get set up, make sure Dexter's got plenty of blankets and we fluff his pillows and he's all good to go. And then we go on our hike. Speaking of Dexter, he is being such a good little boy. I mean, he does put up a tiny bit of a fight when we have to put him in his cage, but then he gets in there and then he just rocks himself to sleep. Well, the truck rocks him to sleep. Thanks, Dee. A lot of people said that we should just let Dexter run free in the truck and not be in a cage. And I'm like, do you even own a cat? Do you understand what claws do to leather seats? Dexter really enjoys his cage. We won't call it a cage. We'll call it a carrier or a crate. He really likes it because he wants that safe space. And for those that said we should like put him up so he could look out the windows,
We've done that before. He don't like it. He doesn't want to see what's out there. He's not a dog. So I just want you guys to know we do see your comments when you're concerned about Dexter. I'm telling you, the guy's doing great. The goal today is to see a bear. We have not seen a bear yet in the flesh.
Now, we don't want to sneak up on a bear. That is a no-no. That is not being very good bear aware etiquette, whatever they call it. We just want to see one from a distance and then be able to like zoom in and get some cool footage. We just want to see it. We're not trying to go and hug it.
Can I touch on that for a second? I want to see a bear snatching a salmon out of the river, put it in its mouth and run away. Like, this is something I've always wanted to see in real life. Let's make it happen.
Well, we may be in luck because supposedly right now the salmon are hot. The salmon are popping and hopping and flopping. We need to talk about Starlink in Alaska. And we'll talk more about this later on, but I just want to give you a little update on Starlink. It is not as resourceful as I thought it was gonna be. Now, Starlink works, but for some reason, it'll be like every 2 to 3 minutes, the signal will just cut out. And there's no obstructions whatsoever. It's got a clear view of the sky. And I think it just has to do with not that many satellites being around. There are satellite stations or whatever they're called in Alaska, like Fairbanks and whatnot. Oh my gosh, sorry, I'm trying to talk to you guys, but you know how the drivers are up here. So with all the RVers being here and Starlink becoming popular, it's just not very good. And it's 2023 right now. Maybe next year, the year after, it'll be better. Something to think about.
See, the weird thing about Alaska is they actually have these turning out lanes where slower vehicles can pull over. And that's not the weird part. The weird part is it's actually illegal to have more than 5 cars backed up behind you. And that's why these turnouts are so frequent. So just keep that in mind in Alaska. I don't know how strict the cops are when it comes to this, but according to Alaska, it's illegal. Utilize those turns. Here we go. Made it to fill up diesel here real quick. Stopped. $3.84 a gallon. Not too bad. I'm not complaining. Nay went through all the CDs that she grew up with going through high school, and it's like reaching into a jelly bean container. You don't know what you're gonna get with these burned CDs. Welcome to a throwback, basically. If you don't know what a CD is, I'm just kidding. are we in that generation now where people don't know what CDs are? We were joking because I don't know if new vehicles even have CD players anymore. Huh. We're gonna save a lot on payload. Getting rid of these. Do workouts with these bad boys. All right, enough dilly-daddling, Carl. Let's fill up. Yeah, not bad at all. Look at these old CDs that Nay grew up with in high school. You know, yeah, look at that.
Classics, what you got?
We got Phantom of the Opera, Nightmare Before Christmas.
What?
It is like you don't know what you're gonna get. Wizard of Oz.
Who is this human?
I don't know.
Hairspray?
Hairspray. Wicked. Now 5.
Yes.
I swear by now, they gotta be on like now 437. I don't know.
What is this one?
Oh, that is Hanson.
Hanson? Oh, I remember Hanson.
Now 18. Renee's been at this a while. All right, now we're gonna save a lot more gas mileage without all those CDs in the truck.
Five miles away, it's almost bear time. Oh my gosh. Biggest struggle is gonna be finding parking for 2 big rigs.
Just looking to park for the day and head, where are we doing this?
Do like a hike.
A hike?
Okay, if you guys want, you guys can probably, are they with you,
behind you?
Okay, if you guys want to, it'd be cheaper just to park down here and less of a hassle because you'd have to unhitch if you wanted to park closer.
Okay.
If you want to just park here, it's $5 per vehicle.
Okay.
And it's a mile though from here to the trailhead.
Okay. Oh, that's probably our best bet because we don't want to, because the trailhead parking lot is too small for us.
Yeah, they are.
Okay.
Five buckaroos. Thank you, ma'am.
How much did he say? Was it 14 or just the 5?
Just 5. He recommends that we, because of our rig size, we park here and then it's like a little less than a mile to walk to the trailhead.
Howdy.
What up?
Nothing.
Okay, so here's the thing. It's like almost 3 miles each way. Uh-huh. Once we're at the trailhead, it's almost a mile to the trailhead.
Yeah.
I would rather drive up and not drive an extra, walk an extra 2 miles.
That sounds good.
But I just think, the 40 minutes to save, I know that sounds silly, but I think it's worth it because we have to drive another hour, don't
yeah.
we?
Yeah.
So I think we should.
Plus it's already 2:30.
I think we should unhook.
All right, Stinky, you ready?
You get to come in and hang out. How does that sound?
All right, much smaller parking lot, but doable. Sorry for making y'all unhook.
The things we do for you guys.
Things we do for love.
2.3 miles.
Let's do it. Sawbears finally to be able to see the fish jumping out of the river. These guys are trying so hard and they're failing a lot too. I gotta give them credit. They are giving their all. I'm like, go buddy, hang in there. I feel like I need like a cheerleader like that for me when I'm driving the RV. Somebody like, yeah, Carl. Finally made it back. 5 miles later, I'm really glad that Keith and Randy came up with the idea of unhooking the rig before we started the hike, or else we would have had to tack on an additional 2 miles, one each way. So they're getting hooked back up. The hike was well worth it. Plenty of parking here if you want to go check it out, the Russian River, and go see it for yourself. The Hanks approved this. Hanks approved. Go do it. We got an hour left. Let's get back out on the road. Stop your yammering, Carl. Let's get it done.
My Nene energy has just like, it's depleted because today has been such a fun and exciting day. We got to see bears in the wild and we didn't have to pay like $1,000 to do a tour to see bears. Like, there they were in the flesh. But you know, because we did this hike in the middle of a travel day, we still have to drive another hour to get to the campground. We're going to Stony Creek RV Resort. And I believe we'll have full hookups. If you're salty and you know it, clap your paws. That is not how it goes.
That is salty.
We're gonna have to work on that. We are pulling into Stony Creek RV Resort. Is it a resort or is it an RV park? I don't really know.
We don't know because every RV park labels it as a resort to attract more RVers.
Yeah, and I'm not calling out any specific place, but there's a lot of ones we've been to that will say resort. And I'm like, where's the swimming pool?
Where's your resort application? Yeah. I want to pull the file on
yeah.
that.
Does anyone know that out there? Like, do you have to have a special permit or license to be called a resort? He's crying because it's almost 7 o'clock.
That's his dinner time.
Yeah, that's the thing I'm learning too, is a lot of these RV campgrounds, we'll just call them a campground. They're like on private property. Like the owners like live right next door, which I love because that means it's like family owned, it's cute. When you come to Alaska and you pull into these RV parks and you're thinking, this is someone's house, you're right, but just keep going. I do appreciate the office this way signs, because that's another thing. If you guys are thinking of opening your own campground, please don't hide the office.
Coming in, we're drifting.
Where's everyone? Just is everyone's?
Looks like there is.
Also the trailer wiring. Again.
I'm gonna put some more dielectric grease on it.
Is that the answer?
Yeah. Of course it's the answer. It's the answer to everything.